parents raising children. Honestly, the age doesn't matter. If you can think for a second, what would it be like to have one parenting philosophy that you can use throughout your children's lives? Wouldn't that be cool? Instead of trying to raise an infant and then trying to raise a toddler and then trying to raise a school-age person, then a middle school, then a high school, then an adult, because they come back to the home sometimes. If you could get a philosophy that would help you all the way, would you take it? Yes. Well, one of the ways you're going to get that, and I'm going to give you the secret today. Recognize what is your responsibility compared to your child's responsibility. A child who's 5 has different responsibilities than a child who's 15. So a child who's 5 can't be responsible to take the trash out, but a child who's 15 can. You're always making sure you keep in your head, what is it that they should appropriately be responsible for? One of the things I learned in graduate school a long time ago was to never do for a child what they can do for themselves. When they know how to tie their shoes, let them learn and struggle and go through the process of tying their shoes, even though they'd rather have you do it. When you give money to a child you have that's in college, let's say, some spending money or a budget for them to kind of get through to get groceries or things to eat, let them learn how to live with that. Most parents end up giving more and more. Well, I ran out of money. I need some extra. I need help. And young people do that too with video games or computers or iPads of, I want more time. I want to get this game. I want to have this. If you can incorporate one word into your parenting philosophy, I would use the word choose. Most parents don't use the word choose. They'll say with really young children, we don't do that in our family. We don't talk that way. We don't act that way. They'll kind of incorporate everybody. I always teach parents to say, choose. If you choose to do that, then you choose to have this consequence happen. It's your choice. If you choose to sleep in late to a teenager, then you choose for me not to take you to practice or to the party. I think too many parents take way too much responsibility for their children. It doesn't mean you can't be there to help out, but you have to learn to set boundaries and say, it's your choice. If you choose not to, this is what happened in our home, if you choose not to feed the dogs before you go to bed at night and put water and food in their bowls, you choose not to have your phone the next day. So if I wake up in the morning and I see that the dog bowls are empty, then just get the phone, you keep the phone. There's no argument. Choose and arguments. Try really hard, parents, to close the mouth and not continue to speak to your child, lecture your child, or beat it into their head about what they did wrong. You just need to put it out there. And you gotta be fair about it up front. I can't go to my teenager and say, oh, by the way, I took your phone because you didn't feed the dogs. But if I never told them to feed the dogs, or if I just generally said, why don't you feed the dogs? I need you to feed the dogs. But I don't put a boundary out, like, here's the deal. If you choose not to take the trash out, not to feed the dogs, not to make your bed, not to clean this up, then you're gonna choose this to happen. That is not fair. I have to put the choice out in front of them first. So use the word choose, try really hard not to argue and debate about it, even if they want the last word, because a lot of young children and teenagers want the last word. It's okay, let them have it. But your parenting philosophy is on accountability, responsibility, integrity, learning to make decisions for themselves. So don't make a 5-year-old be responsible to take the trash out. But you might tell a 5-year-old, I need you to go into each bathroom and get the trash can out of each bathroom and bring it to me. But I want to go outside and play. I need you to get the trash cans out of each bathroom now. Then you can go out and play. If you choose to go out and play and don't bring me the trash cans, then you choose to go to bed early tonight. You're always using the word choose, and you're always letting them decide their consequence and the outcome. What I want you to try and implement, like right now, on top of, don't get into mental, verbal debates and arguments over who's right, whether you're the parent. You just follow through with the consequence. Get out there, try it, let me know how it goes. I can't wait to hear.